Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the Joint Data League. We had ourselves a bit of a break after Asia. I'm now joined by the capitalist here in the live studio, and we are headed to Europe. We're into Europe, man. We're starting off with...
Good game to start out on.
Yeah.
Next versus PR. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Slightly controversial team, but they have been around for a very, very long time and were convicted of nothing. So they are still here to play in the Joint Data League, and they're going up against a team which topples Titans. They're up against Power Rangers.
Mm-hmm. In this matchup, I mean, this is two teams that have gone back and forth for a very, very long time. And so far, Power Rangers have the lead in the record over the last, like, 6 months, which is really what you want to look at. I think they're leading something like 5-3 or something like that. But needless to say, they played up against each other a lot. And, I mean, Next.kz, they do have a certain stand-in, which might prove the difference.
Yeah, they do. They do. We assigned this live stream over on joinDOTA just so it may now look like we have about 30,000 people watching this live stream. But Havorst was pumping it up for the last couple of hours in the day. And it looks like Next.kz said, hey, would you mind just like just standing in? And yeah, they said, hey, can you still do first-person streaming? And we're like, yeah, sure. This is a community this is a tournament for the community. Well, Na'Vi said they wouldn't participate. I guess in some way now they are. And Tavorst will now stand in for Next.kz in the second slot.
Yep, and we're getting this draft underway where we got Alchemist, Invoker banned out by Next.kz, Slark, and Timbersaw taken out by Power Rangers, and the Nature's Prophet first pick. I gotta say, I mean, casting all this Korean Dota, it's a completely different draft now, man.
This for me after this morning's games feels so natural, so normal. Like I know I saw Slark early today on the offlane. Timbersaw hasn't made it through a single game yet, and I had a 1-1 as far as banned and then picked being the Alchemist early today. And also the same for the Invoker. So all of these kind of things seen a lot. And Next.kz with the Nature's Prophet. In a way, I kind of hate Next.kz for doing this because I remember the Next.kz model. Like I used to play with these guys. We would like in the original days of Dota 2 would have like these fun tournaments that were created, and I played a lot with the Next.kz guys, and they basically had one rule and one rule alone: Radiant fight. Team pick. That's the rule. Like, if you sit back and then you start going in for this turtling kind of thing, like, they are the ones who also gave us, like, the worst possible turtling game in all of history, which was MTW versus Next.kz, the TI2 qualifiers for Europe, and no, I will never, ever forget a capitalist. So these guys know how to fight, they know how to split push, and over time they developed a balance between the two of them. And as far as Power Rangers go, these guys... their coordination has always been quite high, and they're always looking for like counter-initiation style lineups because that's what they love. They love aggressive teams to go up against them because then they just hit back and then find these heroes which can then initiate themselves. So you turn from counter-aggression to full aggression, and that's how you win the games.
Yeah, Power Rangers for me has always been a really fun team to watch because they're one of the smaller teams, and yet they've always been around for forever, and they actually provide some wonderful upsets from time to time. So I've actually become more and more of a fan of these guys over time. I used to be one of those guys who was like, oh, great, Power Rangers is playing. But as I've watched them kind of topple some of those top tier one teams, I've become really a really big fan. And I like their drafting already. Very, very open. They're going to go with the Visage Nyx Assassin. Visage, one of the best supports you could possibly pick up. Nyx Assassin is a little farther down when it comes to the tiers of supports that you want to pick up. However, there's a Furion on the other team. And you know automatically you want to be able to have some sort of hero that picks off split pushers. What better support than Nyx Assassin?
Then again, at the same time, too, it keeps Power Rangers open. Like, you're talking about support Nyx Assassin. The solo mid has been no stranger to Nyx Assassin of recent times.
And so offlane.
And offlane.
We've been seeing that.
It's been very... Yeah, I still question the offlane Nyx Assassin.
Hey, my philosophy has been if you are in support of the Elder Titan offlane, then you should be in support of the Nyx Assassin.
No, see, I used to be in support of the Elder Titan offlane, and then his damage got nerfed, and then that was it.
Nerf after nerf, yeah.
Then I revoked my support. Mm-hmm. But I will support a Vorst Luna. It is one of his signature heroes. And I got a feeling like with this lineup, when you've got Nature's Prophet and Luna right now, we're looking at full-on push. Now, they could go speed gaming style. You don't get to see them yet. They're coming up in 3 hours' time. But they can go speed gaming style, which is... I know. I pointed to a camera.
Pointed to a camera that no
sorry,
one sees.
Sorry. They're coming up in 3 hours' time. dick. I can't help it, man! I can't help it. I've been.
You're one of those personalities who's always on camera, isn't it? In your head, someone's always watching you, huh, Toby?
Yes. Yeah, someone's always watching. That's actually rather disturbing. There's some things in life which people do which you should really not observe. unless you're into that kind of thing, at which point, it's your decision. It's all about the community.
No, Toby, it's not all about the community. Sometimes there are some things the community wants that you just can't give.
Moving on. Weaver, pick up here for Power Rangers. So, second time today, I get to cast a Weaver. And, well, the last one wasn't too bad. He ended up with a Lincoln Sphere up at a nice timing rate, mainly because he's going up against Marana, who tried to get a Lincoln Sphere as well. And that didn't really end up going too well. Weaver needs some space to get him farmed up. So, Power Rangers, not 100% what I was looking for from their lineup as far as, like, full-on aggression. But then again, at the same time, there's no reason why they can't run Visage and Weaver up on the top. If Nyx ends up in the middle lane, add another range, aggressive kind of supporter. What I kind of want to see from SKZ is what I was talking about, speed gaming approach, which is Lunar on the off lane is the bonus damage down there. Prophet will TP and help out when he needs to, but you can go for very early game aggression on the long lane. Of course, when they did it, they also used, I think it was Troll, was it Troll Warlord?
In the mid lane?
No, it was like Eternal MV. No, it was Lycan, when they ran the Lycan. And they ran Lycan on the safe lane, and they went like the bonus damage, and then with Luna with her bonus damage and the two range supports, that hero on the bottom lane slightly out of position and toast.
I like the bans out to Power Rangers taking away the DK mid, I think was very, very smart. Any sort of additional push could have absolutely crushed Power Rangers very, very early on. And a big tanky hero that works well with Luna. Meanwhile, Next.kz, they manned out both the Lifestealer and the Clinks. Heroes that are good at being able to... Clinks, for one, is able to very, very strong against those split pushers. And it can provide some early aggression against some of those heroes like Luna who like to be able to spend a little bit of time farming up that jungle. But now we see the Doom.
I like it. I like better if it is going to be Weaver Visage up on top lane, though.
Mm-hmm.
Now Enchantress comes in. So here's our push element we're talking about. It doesn't have to be an aggressive trial lane. It can be a safe lane. Just push out the tower. So Prophet causes issues inside the jungle. Doombringer, more than likely, I think Power Rangers want to put him on the bottom lane. So put the Doom on the bottom. You can take Nyx, Visage, and Weaver all up on top lane. I have no issue with that.
Yeah.
And then just grab up the mid solos, which are now missing for both these lineups.
Yeah, I'm good with that as well, just because Visage is really strong versus Luna in lane. Luna provides a lot of nuking damage, however, that's actually to the benefit of Visage sometimes, where he gets that instant amount of souls, where he's able to provide that big nuke, and Luna is known to be a very, very squishy hero. In conjunction with a Weaver, a hero who's able to get past some of those defenses, like Enchantress, when she comes into lane, is able to throw one of those creeps. Most heroes can't actually fight up against that, because of the fact that the centaurs in front, they're probably going to get stunned if they try and move past the creep. In general, it just provides this sort of blocking mechanism. However, Weaver's one of the few heroes who can get past that, can start do a little Shikuchi damage to Luna and start beating on him. So they can actually fight that if Next.kz put themselves in a bad position or get overly aggressive. Doom, definitely. I mean, there's no way that we're going to see a jungle Doom here, so I'm down with the aggressive trial lane. I think Doom has to pick up that early amount of farm. He's a good team fighter. But he needs that basic amount of farm, and that's going to be seen in lane, not in jungle. So,
yeah. And when you say aggressive trial, and you still mean Doom on the bottom, don't you?
Yeah.
I actually want to see...
Or middle. I mean, if they...
Well, it depends who he's going up against, mm-hmm. but yeah, that could work. I want to see a Doom with the head of Midas to completely destroy the Enchantress.
We're still going... No, I'm...
This
now,
is Nyx mid.
Now I'm not down with this.
Yep.
I was just thinking about this. Like, the Nyx Assassin, I'm good with this as a support. However, like, one of the best things about Nyx Assassin is he's pretty versatile in his laning phase. So you could choose to go mid. I'm not a big fan of this just because, as I can see it right now, Next.kz, a lot of five-manning very, very early on. Now, granted, this is going to be good versus Enchantress and Furion, who will sometimes separate themselves for split pushing or jungling.
Uh-huh.
But I think that Next.kz are going to focus a lot more on five-manning than Nyx Assassin is really going to benefit from. So, I'm not down with this. I think they needed a better team fighter. I think this should have been a Nyx Assassin support.
See, I'm going to reserve my judgment until I start to see the lanes, because I have something going through my head right now for the Power Rangers guys, which is a little bit out of the ordinary. But I want to see if they go anywhere near it before I even talk about it, because obviously, the community is the community, and I don't want to throw myself under this bus unless I actually know there's a crazy clown driving. So we'll find out. Next.kz, we need our last hero, man. So mid-solo, and Mandus has to try and work out to what the hell they are trying to run in that middle lane. You ban out the Storm Spirit as well. You're thinking about jumping initiations. That Mandus took out the Puck, so maybe that was just a counter ban when you see a Puck being removed. Or Storm Spirit being removed, then you're like, okay, let's just take out the Puck. Maybe they're thinking about Sightwheel on these lines, someone that's really susceptible to Orchid-style ganks. And man, it's just got to decide what he's comfortable with in that middle lane. He can't instantly say, I'm going up against the Knicks. And this is what's going through my head right now. I already saw a Weaver go solo mid today. Clockwork will be their final selection. So everyone's going to go something just that little bit different.
I was going to say, they need an initiator here, and it's why Power Rangers took away the Storm Spirit. A really strong hero can initiate, but still actually get out. Most of the time, he would obviously have some troubles with Doom, but in general, he's a strong initiator. Something that Next.kz was really lacking. They've got some really good team fight. They've got some strong push, but the question is, how do they actually force that team fight in a good position for Next.kz instead of just like running at them and hoping Power Rangers make some sort of mistake? Clockwork is going to be the answer. Most of the strong initiators were out of the pool, so they have to go for something that's a little out of the ordinary. And Clockwork being able to jump in, provide the initiation of the hook shot, also the cogs being able to sort of push people back a little bit. That's going to be really, really helpful for when they do go for these pushes, but also look for those pickoffs before they actually go for it. With the Furion being able to provide some of that global damage, it's perfect. Oh, man. I got to change the settings on this computer.
Whew. That's right. I have to change your name on this one. Because for some reason, you're clairvoyant and in the wrong spot. So, hey, new overlay is coming back. There we go. Now Capitalist can slot himself in there on the side.
Right.
And, yeah, so now that we both fix our crap, in we go to the game. So, running through our lanes to start with,
Is the crazy clown that you thought was going to be happening?
I am actually checking through the lanes. Hell yes, it is. Hell yes, it is. So, yeah, what I was thinking was that you're going to run a Doombringer, a hard farmer, a lot of space. That's going to happen. Right. You want to find levels up on him. For the guys who are tuning into the Southeast Asian part of the coverage today, I was also making a comment on this saying Doombringers, really, you want to find those fast levels. It either comes through your movement inside the jungle, and that's having good movement, or it's giving a solo lane in a safer position. So then your other option is just leave him as bottom lane solo. 100% down for that one. And then you run a Weaver in the middle lane. Now, this is a very aggressive hero in the middle lane. It's going to be dangerous. It's basically going up against the Clockwork unless you have an early Observer ward, which is what I'm going to be searching for. Some kind of ward up here on the higher ground, but it's a great kind of combination there. But of course, that says Nyx Assassin. Where does he end up? And that's where the Bane comes in up on this top lane. Nyx Assassin stun is really difficult to latch. And if someone's going to come in range to try and stop that Nyx Assassin, or like stop the Bane's Nightmare, then you can be in range for a possible double stun. So that's when you can really start to capitalize on those moments. And J4 makes it perfect. It's an easy setup. It's an easy way to follow it up. And then you have a Visage on top of all of that. So the combination of PR up on that top lane, it's a really aggressive tri-lane. It is, however, very susceptible to, well, screwing up. So you must make sure you're able to get kills there. And I already seen Next.kz dodging it. Havorse is down the bottom lane. Amazing's down here with him as well. So we have a dual offlaner. We have the young Jedi inside the jungle as the Enchantress, was Reeves up on the top. Keanu Reeves acting is appalling. And then Mantis, Clockwork, the final one in the middle lane.
You know, you get no credit for that. If you had actually manned up and been like, this is what I think Power Rangers is going to do.
Yeah, I know.
You would have gotten all the credit in the world.
I decided not to ride the bus.
Uh-huh. But now people think, oh, yeah, sure, Toby. Sure, that's what you had in mind.
Top lane gank. Hey, at least I haven't missed a first blood tonight, but we should have one up on this top lane.
We'll see.
Young Jedi wants to go. He's got to go in already because the Centaurs are going to time out shortly. So he'll look for Nyx or Bane. He needs support to be closer, and this is the reason why he didn't want to come up to start with. Because if he does so, now he puts himself in a position where he could possibly get killed off.
Dear.
So the first stun, it's only Nightmare though, so there's nowhere near enough damage to kill him off. But on bottom lane, there's a pickup already. That's on FNG, dragging him back, and they get the first blood too. Rubik with the Fade Bolt and that Loosen Beam. A lot of right-click harassment damage, and they'll just push that Doombringer back off the lane. He went for the Frost Attack minion to start with, because that was all he found. He had nothing else to give.
Yeah, it's one of those situations where they what they should have done is they should have had a support. Like, they should have had the Visage actually in lane and have Doom. It's always worth it for Doom to pick up one of those big creeps. Like, having that having one of the small creeps, because he just wanted to get back to his lane as soon as possible. What a lot of people do when they choose to have Doom laning is they put a support in lane for the first 45 seconds that allows Doom to actually find that big creep and get back to his lane without losing any team gold or experience. That's really something they should have done here, because something small like a regen aura or an armor aura could have possibly saved Visage's life there.
Mm-hmm. The problem is when you don't have your time to do everything you want to do in life.
Yeah.
Reeve's getting very, very close here on the side. He's already managed to pull his creep wave over to the Wild Wings. He's going to miss a little bit of the... Oh, no, he's not. The tower started attacking on the healthy creep on this top lane. So I was about to miss some experience, but he's going to be okay. Middle lane's looking really good for Mantis right now. Like, he's 10 for 3 up against a Weaver who's 8 for 2. And just the ability to zone out a Clockwork as a Weaver is such a simple thing to do until that kind of stuff happens. Cogs pop up, and you get pushed back. Bottom lane, looks like Visage will go down. Doombringer, he's trying to have a crack at Rubick, but a Force is body blocking him out for now.
Beautiful.
He's going to lose a beam available as well, and because there's no right click, Amazing is able to use his salve. So a Force and Amazing will go back up to full life again.
He's got to take the time to find a better creep. That's just what it comes down to. He really, like, this cold is not going to do anything, especially now that Rubick has boots.
Yeah.
Like, it's just impossible for him. Meanwhile, the matchup, you know, Weaver versus Clockwork, it's no surprise that Weaver has fallen behind in CS. It's so hard. A lot of times, Weaver, you use Shikuchi a lot, not only just to harass, but to pick up CS. And he can't do that up against a Clockwork, because every single time he disappears, Mantis instantly pops the cogs, and ZXC just ends up hitting himself. So... this whole lane is going to go the way of Clockwork. So far, Next.kz taking a very, very early lead. Taking a look at the CS. I mean, just the control offered to them, the kills. Everything is going Next.kz's way. And that's really, really good considering you have a hard carry Luna. They've got a pushing lineup. All they had to worry about was the laning phase. And that's going great.
Yeah, their laning phase couldn't have really gone any better. Like, when you're able to run an offlane dual lane and not only, like, not die, but get two kills on that bottom lane, both of them going to a support, which means early arcane boost, which means also early level sixes are going to be coming in the way of Rubick. And then you got an Enchantress, who's helping to just pressure on the top lane, but is finding a lot of farm inside the jungle. So anything which Prophet was missing out in the early stages has already been picked up by the Enchantress. She's sitting at 20 for 0 on her CS. And Mantis is about to crack level 6 in the middle lane. He's got an Illusion Runes coming in rather close to ZXC there. But again, burns off the mana, slows him down. He'll pop the Illusion Rune now, and he'll have to bottle himself up before ZXC. He's not gonna go that balls deep, man. Yeah, but... when he hits level 6, then a rotation to bottom lane will come, but it's already come from PR. Bane sitting down here in the wings, just looking for that one person they can nightmare up, but it was seen coming. The Observer was down there, is also blocking up the camp, not to mention watching the rotation in.
Yeah, really good warding so far by Next.kz, both the Rune Ward to be able to give them a little bit of vision of the side of seeing when the medium camp and even some vision over the cliff, but also that aggressive ward being able to block the camp but also give them some really good vision. Just in general, Next.kz are outplaying Power Rangers everywhere they go.
Mm. Yeah, this Doombringer now with phase boots. Maybe this Frost attack he is trying to work to its advantage and chase down a Vorst. It'll be quite successful if he's able to do it. But they do still need that setup. They still need Bane to get the Nightmare off so Doom is able to get in front of him and start attacking directly. But that's going to be so difficult to do. He's almost up to level 6. And it's only 2 kills going the way of Next.kz. This bottom lane, we still have to think about how's it going to transition into more. Oh, hello, level 6 on Clockwork. Hookshot down.
Oh!
Hits it absolutely perfectly. Down onto the Doombringer. There's still a Rubick Telekinesis available, so I'll pick him up, drop him down, lose some beam to start with. Fae Bolt as well going at the same time. And that's a dead Doombringer. FNG, one more loose and beam. He needs vision. Someone give him vision. Clockwork Rocket, it's on cooldown. Havos won't be able to get the second kill here.
Real top. They picked up the Furion kill. Finally, they do get the kill on him. Nyx Assassin used his Vendetta. All it took was Furion eventually getting in range of an impale, and it was going to be an easy kill. So, with J4 joining on with the extra nuking damage, easy, easy kill for them. But it also means we're not going to see that rotation from Nyx Assassin just yet, and he really needs to gank that bottom lane before Luna hits level 6.
Clockwork was playing with a life right then of FNG. He tried to throw a rocket down to find him next to the tier 2 tower. Thought he delayed his retreat a little bit. The second rocket into the wall would have got the instant kill onto the Visage. First one wouldn't have done the job. Really good to see. Again, Next.kz, they keep their minds open. They look for the ganking. That was a very obvious rotation. Mm-hmm. Like, it was so obvious, the fact that I called it out before it even happened. It was an obvious rotation. You run a Beastmaster, you run a Clockwork in the middle lane. You're looking to change your other lanes. That's what that's all about. It's an initiation. You said at the end of the draft, you needed something that was going to do it. And yeah, Enchantress, Nightmare, going to hold it there. She's got 2 points up, and now the Eclipse of Ors.
Oh,
he's
going to
die
stun.
So quickly. They focus him down. Now the Soul Assumption comes in from the Visage, and Mr. Young Jedi may not grow up. He's going to get... He's going to get back to his tower. PR do bring in everybody to stop that, though.
Yeah, they saw the Enchantress out of position. Nick's Assassin instantly went for the teleport and instant Vendetta. His rotation is really what saved that. Luna, very, very early on, Nick's Assassin provides a lot in teamfights against the Luna because you have at least one of those Lucent Beams that are going to go back into Luna, and she's so squishy that you can't afford to have that extra damage on her. So that's until she picks up a BKB, they can't really go for the five-man team fights. And that is one bad thing about running Luna in the aggressive Trine lane. However, she obviously had such a fantastic lane that she's not actually missing any sort of CSs. She's topping out the board right now at 40 and 16. So, but now they're going to put her in the safe lane. They know they need the next 10 minutes for her to be able to farm up that BKB.
Yeah, it's the perfect time to switch out as well because Nature's Prophet about to hit the Henna Midas Gold. So he can go inside the jungle. And the fact that he didn't even TP down for that or even throw an ultimate. Like, I went back up there. It's like, oh, hey, he's got his ultimate up and running. And he's well past level 6. So decide to even hold it then. It's possible killing a Bane at one point. But top lane, FNG, I don't know if he's really ready for this. No. They want to apply pressure to a Vos, but they'll pick him up, throw him back, and FNG is going to die very quickly. Brain Sap or no Brain Sap, Prophet TP's in front, sprouts him up, TP out, won't have enough time, especially with the Lucid Beam adding its mini stun into the mix. And Nick's Assassin's over on the side here. He wants a pick off on Amazing. That's what he wants right now. A Vendetta hit into a stun. He won't get himself away to safety if he tries it, though. And now, in fact, he gets earned up as well, which is over on the Enchantress. And he just can't find one hero out of position because they're all grouping up to push onto the tier 1 tower on the top.
Yeah, that was just bad communication there. They had the Nyx Assassin wanted to go the long way around to find something in the jungle, and he never actually found it. So they ended up going too far forward in lane, thinking that he was going to be ready for that rotation, but he was just too far out in the jungle, besides the fact that they need more numbers, because having those two supports top, plus the fact that Furion can come in, even if they had a successful, like a three-man attempt at a gank, you would still be outnumbered. So they need to keep that in mind. They need to keep in mind the fact that the Furion has been farming up very, very well, and as long as his ultimate is up, he actually provides a lot in those small skirmishes. So they got to be careful in that regards. And so, I don't know, man. I don't know how Power Rangers are going to be able to deal with this because now, Next.kz, they're well ahead right now.
Yeah, they take a tower. They snipe out runes. This is just really good watching from Next.kz as well. Man has pinged out the fact that ZXC was shikuching down south to try and pick up that rune. So Reeve just TPs in. He takes it out as well. They group up as like a full team, as you said. Like, the strength is in numbers for Next.kz, and rightly so. PR, they need timing, they need something, but what are we looking at? Doombringer's on the bottom lane with 1,800 gold. Are we looking at him to build into a Radiance? He won't survive the five-man pushes if he does so. If Weaver still wants to go towards a Lincoln Sphere, then you've got more troubles, because you won't have the damage by the time Next.kz is looking to go high ground. And then you got your other guy who's your core, Nick's Assassin. Blink Dagger Initiation might be one way to do it, but he's a long way off having that. And Doombringer, he's going to go Hand of Midas. So I was thinking that anyway to get rid of the Enchantress, as I actually called out about maybe 5-10 minutes ago. But at this stage of the game, I'm still wondering if that's going to be enough. The more time that goes on, the better Doom is going to get. That's this big upside right now. But if Next.kz like put the pedal to the metal, then they should be able to make a very large dent in PR, one which I don't think even Hand of Midas Doom can, well, repair.
Yeah, pretty much with this build, it says that Power Rangers are avoiding any and all fights for the next. Do it.
Okay, go. Nyx Assassin.
Oh.
Come on, Vendetta hit. Follow up stun. Mana burn. Clockwork's gonna hookshot in though, and that's what Manus is waiting for. He sat in the sides, and now Nyx Assassin is stuck. He's already used Spy Carapace. The TP of Rubik helped to have him extra bit of control. That's what I was just saying. Do it, do it, do it. Because you knew what was coming in the wings from Next.kz. They waited perfectly for that.
Yeah, it's one of those things as a Nyx Assassin core, you really have to pay attention to the items that are picked up by some of the cores for Next.kz. And like something small like a Belt of Strength and the amount of the levels that are up on the Nature's Prophet should tell you, I can't kill him until I'm level 11. Even though Nyx Assassin is supposed to be this really strong, well, actually, Doom. Uh-oh. He actually throws down the Doom on Mantis. Mantis just walks away. Like, he should be completely fine. He threw a Doom on a Strength here. There's not much chance of actually being able to pick up that kill.
Yeah, but with the sole assumption, they thought maybe they're going to have a crack over at Reese, but a Vorse is now TP'd in. You've still got the extra hero over here. The Observer Ward was down, but it wasn't for the Dire Sign, so they didn't see up on the hill, or else that Rubick would have just been dragging back one of the PR guys. He gets the Lucent Beam, seeing around tree lines to get that kill.
This is just a disaster. They can't fight this. With a Weaver and a Midas Doom, there's no way. Yep. Like, Power Rangers have to stay away from all these fights. That's why you pick up the Midas.
Oh, they do have one, though. Young Jedi over on the side, able to Shikuchi him down after Nyx Assassin got a good stun off.
Well, something small, but still, back up. Like, you can't fight up against the Luna at this point in time.
That is true, man. That is true. But it's a tier 1 tower, and they get a 1-for-1 trade.
Yeah.
It could have been a lot worse. It really could have been a lot worse. And Doombringer is still using its hand of Midas. He's still devouring. And while the CS like still looks great for Next.kz because they got 70 over on Luna, they got 71 over on the Prophet, the next two belong to Weaver as well as Doom. And their two heroes at the Net West really going to start to stretch up. 4.8k, 4.5k. As Devour gets up in levels, it's up to level 3 now. I still don't want to count out the Power Rangers as far as this hidden money, because you don't think the income is really there. But when you keep doing rockets like that, you're always going to keep tabs on when they put that income into new items. Mana saw it perfectly.
Yeah, now Next.kz pretty much have all the time in the world. You could see Havos is building into that. He wasn't really worried about these early rotations, so he even went for the Helm of Dominator before the BKB, which means he's going to have a lot more farm in the next 10 minutes unless somehow Power Rangers shut him down. You're still waiting on ZXC. Like, I think he has to go a BKB here on a Weaver. Just because the team fight, like, you know, once a Luna gets a trap
right now. It's on the Nyx Assassin. Clockwork's gonna hookshot himself in. This mainly for the cogs to split up the fight. ZXC, he's up on the high ground, searching to kill off the Enchantress, which is difficult to do with those little sprites bouncing around. Probably will go through. Mantis, he sees the timelapse back, throws the rockets up towards the high ground to just see FNG throwing out Soul Assumption after Soul Assumption, and now Havorst turns on the heat. They put down that Sentry Wall before the fight even started, moving down towards the Bane. The cogs go down, trying to burn off the last point of his mana, lock him into a corner, one more rocket, and the Fabled out from the Rubick. Man is able to get himself out to safety before the creep wave locked him into the tree line, but there will definitely be the death of the Rubick. Possible to Gnarly's peeing himself out right now, saying, Avorce, please attack me, and Avorce says no, he will never kill off his own teammate, but Power Rangers, they've killed themselves off. It's four on the sidelines, about to become the five. It's a nice double stun, but Avorce takes the aggro of the tower, as well as the second kill over on the Knicks to give himself a double, and the mid-tier one tower to now take a fall.
Yeah, and Mantis, with picking up a Blade Mail like this, it just gives them even more potential teamfight. Mantis with the early levels, FNG.
There's not enough mana following.
Fine. Yeah. If he had Hookshot, which is up in just another 2 seconds, that would have been another easy pickoff for them. But now with the Necronomicon minions, like, you have all of this teamfight. Power Rangers can't do anything to stop it. They have to go for some heavy, heavy split push. I would almost go as far as to say that ZXC almost needs, like, a Desolator just to be able to provide enough split push, like, actual scare against some of those Tier 2 towers that forces Next.kz back. Mm-hmm. At this point in time, I don't see any real way they're going to be able to stop once Necronomicon 3 is up.
He just picked up an ultimate orb.
Yeah. Like, he has to worry eventually, especially with the Furion not going for a fast Scythe of Ice. I really don't agree with this. Maybe if Furion was going for a fast Scythe of Ice, you could think about it, but he's going Necro 3. Okay. That just happened.
I believe he attacked a Necro unit.
Yep.
And then Prophet Oli bounced straight through him.
He's like, I've got full health. I'll be fine. This is good gold right here. Furion ultimate just tears him apart afterwards.
Yep. It's the reason why you don't mess with a Prophet, man. You never find yourself in low life. Because he'll just chase you down and find you. Havorst is about to finish up his BKB. In fact, yeah, there it is. So he has it, and they're heading over towards Roshan. Prophet will TP in a moment. He's got no trees. He can't spawn him yet. He's got another 15 seconds. But with Hellbear, Centaur, and Alpha Wolf, And then they just put Enchantress on the front lines. Roshan has the slowest return attack of all time. All Enchantress has to do is tank it up, and they've got this in the bag. And a Vorce with a DD rune as well. Okay, Aegis belongs to them, and they'll still get back in time to defend their tier 1 tower on top.
What I love about Next.kz's lineup here is it's such an easy checklist to think about. You look at the two, really it's just two cores you want to think about. Luna, do you have level 2 ultimate, and do you have BKB? Like, that's all you need for your push. You actually don't need a whole lot of damage up on Luna before you go for these team fights. As long as your ultimate is up and it's level 2, it's a huge boost to your team fights, and as long as you have BKB, you have the survivability.
Oh no! Prophet! Fiendscript up! I thought next level play. I really thought next level play for a moment. The idea was to go up there, create an army of trees, pop your necro units, because he used a TP scroll to go up to the tier 1 tower, and then he wanted to TP with his ability, teleportation, down to the bottom lane, and then they would push the tier 2, then they'd push the tier 3. And Luna would have come in to join him, but right now Havorce is sitting in no man's land, because he has no TP scroll. He picked up his Ring of Basilius again. And now we have ourselves with this weird position where Havorce is defending in the mid. They'll find a tier 2 for a tier 1 tower trade as Enchantress takes out the bottom and top 1 will belong to the Doombringer. But the push from PR can't stop here. They've got to force it up to the tier 2 tower up on the top and force Next.kz to rotate up and try and fight them directly. This is the only way I see him getting ahead in this game. Prophet will try and slow him down, but they can work through it. In fact, they're going to say screw it. They're TPing out. Nyx doesn't have enough mana or life points.
If they could keep forcing those kind of rotations, put Next.kz on the back foot, like, I don't think Next.kz actually have to address these pushes. Like, Furion teleporting in, I think that's just getting greedy. Like, that's you trying to save a tier 1, even though you could have made the change of a tier 1 for a tier 2. Like, that's just getting greedy trying to save it. As long as Next.kz 5-man and go towards a tier 2, there's nothing Power Rangers can do to stop them. So all they can hope is just to slow them down with split push.
They saw for a moment, Necrogears are popping off. They saw Nyx Assassin for a split moment. Doombringer is going to come in right now and he's going to look to help out. Then again, at the same time, they've already doomed up over on the Rubik. They don't want him stealing anything. Reed's going to get stunned up. It's a perfect position for the Nyx Assassin, but now Avorce turns on the heat as well as the BKB Eclipse. Three of his comrades are down. While Doom and Visage, they lost their lives from Power Rangers and the tier 2 tower also took a fall.
Well, that was a great team fight. I mean, for Power Rangers, that's more than I really expected them. They still lost a tier 2. They still traded a 2 for 3. But Weaver's still alive. That's the important thing. They picked up a couple of kills. It's not a bad team fight for them.
No. It was quite good, all things considered. Mm-hmm. And now you see ZXC is about to finish up his Lincoln Sphere. This is looking a lot better for them. He may even consider going into a mana style at this point. But once he got TP scroll, it's definitely going to be Lincoln's.
Yeah, but what's a Lincoln's really going to do for him in these team fights? I mean,
wait, you stop a Lucid Beam for a moment?
Yeah, or he stops Telekinesis from holding him in place. You know, there's even though there isn't a whole lot of big disables up on Next.kz that can hold down a Weaver, and with that Lincoln's, it pretty much ensures he will get off his ultimate.
Yeah.
There's still just enough firepower, pure firepower up on Next.kz that is a 5-man group they can't do much about. There you go. And now J4 might be in trouble, especially when Nyx Assassin misses that.
Stun was ballsed up, and that means the Gem's on the deck. Nyx Assassin's going to try and come in, and he steals it.
Too.
He spied Carapace and stole it. And right now, Amazing's on his tail. He's got 4 start to fall in if he really needs to, but Fae Bolt's are down, and that is a very expensive pickoff. Both the Bane and the Nyx down, the Gem being lost, and you already have an Aghanim Scepter over on Mantis. This guy is 21 minutes in, and he'll be hookshotting into anybody even roughly sees. Like, even this Doombringer right now if he wants to, but not going to happen.
Weaver got the deny at top, but again, like, Next.kz, they're like, meh. I mean, it's just a tower. We're about to go uphill. Doesn't matter if a tier 2 does get denied. We have everything we need. We have Necronomicon 3, so the two Invis heroes can't come forward. We've got enough firepower to quickly take down towers.
Oh, young Jedi.
It's pretty far forward, but...
Yeah. But the damage just wasn't there to follow up directly after. I'm like, what's Doombringer got? Speed Aura? Yeah, that's going to help you. Familiars are out in the front lines right now getting sniped off. They're just having trouble cleaning up the creep wave. And now Avorce will come in. And remember, Towers of Down has got 4 points up in Glaives. The Bouncers will just destroy these support heroes if they try and come in close. And he's still got Lifesteal, still got Aegis the Immortal. And ZXC able to get his time lapse off, but the Impair's still flying out. Nice stun. Amazing's going to get picked off right now. And maybe CT is in through the rear for the moment. But then the bounce is through again. Another loser beam to help pick off Bane while Mana's out in the front lines. He's got himself a hook shot available. They take out the melee Rax. And you got Next.kz who is sitting there with 4 out of their 5 heroes still up. Hook shot in, and he goes onto a Necro unit. But the GG is called out from Power Rangers. This is, of course, a 2-game series, so this fight is not done yet. But Next.kz will claim the first win in the European series for the joinDOTA League.
Yeah, really well done by Next.kz. I mean, you can't even hold that to, like, I know a lot of people are like, oh no, Havos is playing the stand-in. Good thing I didn't bet rares or something like that. But honestly, that game had nothing to do with Havos. He had some nice plays, but in general, that was just a well-executed strategy by Next.kz. They picked a 5-man push lineup, and they did well in their laning choice by putting the Lunate and the Rubick at that bottom lane. As long as the laning phase went well, there was pretty much nothing to stop them from taking all the tier 1s, tier 2s, and a couple of mistakes by Power Rangers just meant they could push in even earlier than what would normally be 25 to 30 minute uphill push, instead 20-22 minute uphill.
Yeah, this is nice early game Dota. Love it when it's played this way. Stay tuned, there's going to be more of it coming up. We've got both game number 2 of PR versus Next.kz, as well as later on tonight, Team Empire will be playing up against Speed Gaming. There will also be Virtus Pro going up against Life. There's a couple of other guys that will be streaming that one out, and that one will begin in about 3 hours' time from now. In fact, Speed Gaming versus Team Empire is scheduled to start at, I believe it is 17. I'm going to check my own post just to check it out. It's 19 CET is Speed Gaming versus Team Empire, and then we go into Team Liquid up against Sad Boys at 21 CET. That's what's up for grabs, up for your viewing pleasure on the joinDOTA Red live stream tonight. But as always, you can check the details out of all the live streams. We're assigning them all over at joinDOTA.com, and you can check out all those details there, including the details of the joinDOTA League as well as your own divisions. If you don't know about the joinDOTA League, well, you know the place. I already said it. Find the details, and we'll see you back here shortly for game number 2.